Sometimes hypertension doesn't mean that a patient should immediately start to take drugs. Lifestyle modification may lead to long-term stabilization of the blood pressure. In this video, we will speak about non-pharmacological interventions for the treatment of hypertension according to the current guidelines. According to current guidelines, lifestyle interventions should be used in the treatment of hypertension or elevated blood pressure together with drugs or in some case alone. Lifestyle interventions can prevent or delay the onset of hypertension, prevent or delay the need for drugs therapy, improve the efficiency of pharmacological therapy, and reduce cardiovascular risks. But many patients are poorly adherent to the lifestyle changes, and they stop it quickly. Healthy diet shows the most significant effect on blood pressure lowering. Diet is rich in vegetables, fruits, whole grains, fish, nuts, and unsaturated fatty acids. Sugar-sweetened drinks should be restricted as they are associated with overweight, metabolic syndrome, diabetes mellitus, and increased cardiovascular risk. The views on coffee and tea consumption are controversial. Despite the direct vasopressor effect, their intake may be associated with better cardiovascular prognosis. But tea has some blood pressure lowering effect. Products containing a large amount of saturated fat as well as trans fat should be restricted. This all are characteristics to the DASH diet that is commonly used in the US and a Mediterranean diet that is widely used in Europe. Such diet reduces blood pressure, glucose, and lipid levels. Dietary sodium restriction is also important. High sodium intake is associated with increased risk of mortality and cardiovascular events. Less than 1.5 mg of sodium a day is an important goal in normalization of the blood pressure. According to European Society of Cardiology recommendation, salt restriction to less than 5 grams per day is recommended. Enhanced intake of the dietary potassium is associated with blood pressure reduction and reduced risk of cardiovascular diseases. It's recommended to intake from 3,500 to 5,500 mg of potassium a day, but it shouldn't be considered in patients with a significantly impaired renal function. Weight reduction is another important method of non-pharmacological interventions. Ideal body weight should be the main target. This means that the body mass index should range from 20 to 25 kilograms square meter. But at least 1 kilogram reduced in body weight is very important for overweight people. Moderation in alcohol consumption is recommended to reduce blood pressure. In the US, consumption of alcohol is advised up to 2 drinks daily for men and up to 1 drink daily for women. One drink contains 40 grams of pure alcohol. According to European Society of Cardiology recommendations, alcohol consumption should be limited up to 12 units a week for men and 8 units a week for women. One unit equals 10 milliliters of pure alcohol. Smoking significantly increases the risk of stroke, angina, myocardial infarction, peripheral artery disease, and cancer. Also, regular physical activity should be recommended. According to American Heart Association guideline, aerobic dynamic exercises, for example, walking, swimming, cycling, for 90 to 150 minutes a week is advised. For additional benefit in people with elevated blood pressure, gradual increase in duration of aerobic physical activity up to 300 minutes a week is recommended. For these patients, intensive aerobic physical activity with a duration of 150 minutes a week may be considered. According to European Society of Cardiology guideline, aerobic exercises at least 30 minutes of moderate dynamic exercise on 5 to 7 days a week is recommended. Dynamic resistance training with a duration of 90 to 150 a week is recommended. Role of isometric exercise is then established. They are performed for 4 exercises per session with a duration of 2 minutes of each exercise. 1 minute rest is spent between exercises. 3 sessions per week are performed. Regular physical activity is associated with reduced mortality. According to European Society of Cardiology guideline, lifestyle advice is recommended of all patients with a blood pressure of 130 to 85 millimeters mercury or higher. In patients with high normal blood pressure, lifestyle changes are recommended. But if a patient has very high cardiovascular risk due to cardiovascular disease, pharmacological treatment may be considered. A patient with grade 1 hypertension should be recommended to do lifestyle interventions. If a patient has low or moderate cardiovascular risk without hypertension-mediated organ damage, only lifestyle interventions should be advised. But if this patient remains hypertensive after 3 to 6 months of lifestyle interventions, blood pressure-lowering drugs should be prescribed. If a patient with grade 1 hypertension has high or very high cardiovascular risk, cardiovascular disease, renal disease, or hypertension-mediated organ damage, pharmacological treatment should be used immediately in combination with lifestyle interventions. Immediate blood pressure lowering drug treatment in combination with lifestyle advice is recommended for patients with grade 2 and grade 3 hypertension. According to the American Heart Association guidelines, patients with elevated blood pressure are recommended to do lifestyle interventions. In patients with stage 1 hypertension, 10-year cardiovascular risk should be estimated by ASCVD calculator. If it's less than 10%, only lifestyle interventions with the following reassessment in 3 to 6 months should be recommended. If it's 10% and more, lifestyle modifications should be combined with pharmacological treatment. Combination of lifestyle modification and pharmacological treatment is recommended for patients with stage 2 hypertension. It's important that lifestyle interventions should never delay blood pressure lowering therapy when it's indicated. In patients with white coat hypertension, lifestyle interventions should be recommended. If masked hypertension is detected, lifestyle interventions in combination with blood pressure lowering treatment is recommended. Thank you for watching this video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more of our videos, please subscribe and hit the like button.